It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie Kiss Breakfast. Right now, we're joined by the big man himself, Wiley.
Yay, yeah. He's here.
Wow, what's going on, bro?
I made it. Do you notice I walked out my door, there was an Addison Lee. I walked past it, jumped in my car and drove off.
So, Wiles, I want to talk about the new album firstly.
Yes.
The Ascent is out April the 1st, right?
Yes.
You got some big names on this album, man.
Yes,
I want to talk about some of the names that excite me. Kano on there.
Yep.
Gets Lethal B. You got Miss D as well on there.
Yeah,
cool. Got Far East Movement Angel as well. Tinchy Strider, JME, Emily Sandé, J2K as well.
That's a big album.
So many names.
It's a big album.
I don't mean to stand on the fence right now.
Yep.
What tune's going to make you the most money?
Heatwave.
Seriously? Really?
Yeah, the thing with Heatwave is it was really timed well. Not by me.
Okay.
Just by the pluggers and that. Not by me. It was timed well. And timing sometimes is a thing, because obviously since I did that, like, everyone's woke up, everyone's releasing, everyone's come back from the dead, everyone's come back from the, you know, like, everyone's on it. And that's when it gets messy, because people who are bigger than you, who have just got that solid fan base, don't have to do anything. They just pop out and sell.
Yeah.
So it's a big, massive, like, it's massive. I didn't realise, you know, until after. I thought, well, it ain't just me, because he's trying to release, she isn't. Yeah, mad.
Wiley, in terms of albums as well, is it true that this is the penultimate album? So you're doing one more after that, and then that's it. Is that the truth?
Yeah.
Don't give me that, Wiley.
Yeah. Seriously?
Yeah, because I'm 34. I don't need to work past 40.
Are you serious?
I don't need to work past 40. I'm that good.
But what are you going to do?
Well, I've got Roll Deep Crew as mine. I've got Boy Better Know. I've got like a whole scene of people. But away from that, I know what Bob, who don't do nothing what I do, but he works behind that office, who's Kane in the dough. That's where I want to go, where Bob, because you know, like, I'm out here breaking my neck recording, thinking this is where the dough is, and it's not.
So penultimate album, Wiley. The thing is, the thing about you saying that is, I hope you're wrong.
Yeah, but I know.
A good friend of yours who we know, I won't name names, a good friend of yours who we know says that you're the person the most in the world that changes his mind all the time.
I do.
You change your mind daily. You could be like, today I'll be like, I'm retiring tomorrow. And then tomorrow
you'll
be like...
Not retirement talk, though, because retirement talk's quite serious. You wouldn't retire unless you've had enough.
Right.
Unless you've been doing it for that long.
Yeah. But it's fair to say you change your mind all the time.
I do, but not when I've been doing music on a stage performing to people for 20 years.
Right.
It's a different story. Like, them kids have only just... I've met them in 2003. They've been on a stage since 5. And you know what I mean? But I've been on the stage since... Before
the
Dizzy,
thing is,
bro.
Yeah. I've seen videos of you on YouTube spitting at youth clubs in East London. Bro, it's hilarious. It's hilarious from back in the day, spitting bars, and then the fight breaks out.
Yeah.
And then I see you stopping the fight.
Trying to stop it. And then this one's trying to throw that one off the roof. And this
from back in the day.
But yeah. I want to do that because I've learned that where I spill my guts at is not where the money is.
Right.
And then I meet Bob, as I say, and he's over there talking to me about, Wiley, where's your publishing, mate? We're going to sort that out. And I'm thinking, my publishing?
Are you aware that them jobs can be 9 to 5 and you ain't the best person to turn up on
time? Do you know the truth? I work harder than a 9 to 5.
Yeah,
it's true.
I wake up at 7 in the morning, I work, I sit at a computer screen like this all day in the kitchen standing up.
Wiley, why don't you get a chair?
I know, because the chair makes you relax.
Right, yeah, that's true. That's
try a stool.
I have a stool, you know, like, but as I'm saying, like, say if I'm standing up and I'm in that email trying to see where the next couple millions come from, I have to be on my feet.
To stand up.
Trust me.
Oh, it's too funny. Yeah. So, Wiley, I've got some myths here, some Wiley myths that I want you to try and clear up for us, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so is it true that you bought a Bentley,
but
you lived on an estate?
No, when I had a Bentley, I had my house that is in the council estate, where my children live.
Then
I had one down there and I had one up north.
So you had property.
Yeah, but my car was, like, I pulled up outside the council... But no, the car was not parked outside the council.
We were told by our producer on Big Brother a little while ago that you were supposed to appear on one of the spin-off shows for Big Brother, but you didn't watch the show too much, so you sent your friend along to talk for you. So when they were expecting you to turn up, They were like, "Where's Wiley?" You were like, "No, I'm sending my friend. He watches it more than I do.
Big brother.
He's gonna go.
Please tell me that's true.
Is that true?
Yeah.
So tell us what happened. Tell us exactly what happened.
No, basically, you gotta be careful with Big Brother. You have to be like, I was nearly gonna go on there.
Right.
You know, like, when you actually go into the show.
No, don't do it.
Because sometimes you're in your career. Nothing ain't going in.
Yeah.
You think, what should I do? No one cares about my life.
That
I'm going to do that.
No one cares about my life.
That's what you do, though. That's what you do. But luckily, I made Heatwave. Yeah.
If it wasn't for Heatwave,
yeah, would have been I might have gone in there.
Right. Instead of Agro Santos, man.
No, Romeo.
Romeo.
I'm saying, but Romeo's my Don who needs to go in there. Like, not in a bad way. Not in a bad way, in a good way.
Romeo or Harvey?
The fact that Romeo went in there would bring him back.
Yes, that's what you're saying.
If I go in there, it is not going to bring me back. It's going to kill me.
Yeah.
Funny you should mention Romeo from So Solid Crew. So Solid Crew have just reunited for a reunion.
Yes, I can't wait to go.
It's
going to
be big, right? Looking forward to it. I remember hearing you on radio back in the day
with them,
with So Solid, like on a Sunday. So Solid Sundays.
It's sold out.
Sold out. But there's rumors. Now, like I said, these are myths.
Yeah.
The pay-as-you-go cartel might be doing a reunion as well. Is that true? And would you be involved?
Not with me, but they are. If they could be doing it alone, but I wouldn't do that. No.
Why not?
Because I'm just like a bit tired. I'm like, I'm tired. I ain't got the energy for them. Hey, not in a bad way. I love them. You know what though? Let's remember one person from Pay As You Go.
Good.
Major Ace is the reason I stand here today. Major
really?
Ace.
Nice.
It used to be Matt. Like I thought it was Max or D. It weren't. It was Major Ace and DJ Slimzy.
Really?
Right.
Brought me in. But yeah, I can't mess with them.
Today. And also, you had the lyric from back in the day. It started, "My name's William and I'm gonna make a million."
Yep.
Have you made a million?
Yeah. But.
Looking,
no, but I didn't, when I said it, obviously I didn't know, did I? I was just saying anything.
That necklace
saying.
Has got to be worth a million. That
No.
Talking of, I want to talk about comebacks. We had Justin Timberlake in the studio a couple of weeks ago. Now, obviously, you're really honest about everything in life. A lot of people were coming out and saying his first track, Suit and Tie, weren't no good. It's not what they used to. But what do you think of his comeback? Do you think it's good? Do you think?
Nah, it's the same thing as he's done.
Do you think?
Yeah, he can't proceed what he's done. I prefer the film In Time. Wicked film. Not in a bad way. Not in a bad way. Oh, they're killing. No, not in a bad way. Timberlake's. No, listen. No, big up Timberlake. Big up Timberlake.
Please just stay on this show.
You know why I'm the glad, best, though? You know why I'm glad Timberlake's. You know why I think Timberlake's came out again, I think. He came out to ruffle Conor Maynard's feathers. That's why he come out, because. That's why I think, that's not his reason, but I think Conor Maynard's quite similar to him. I heard a JLS song that was quite similar to him.
Right.
He's come back out. To me, he just sounds like he's gone around Timberland for half hour and just sat. but I'm not dissing him because, again, he was number one. The new one was number one.
Yeah.
I listened to it, I thought, wow, it sounds like the other song from his other album.
Yeah.
But he's Timberlake's.
Yeah.
And that's what I mean when someone comes back, like Robbie Williams, and he might not do Nike, but his song is just going
to
pop because he has put the years in.
So recently, Kanye West, massively famous rapper in the world, very, very talented, he went on a bit of a rant because there was a list in the US of the 10 best rappers in the world right now, okay? Mm. And he was placed at number 7. So he didn't like that, went on a massive rant. Where do you think he should be in the top 10 in the world?
No,
and also, who's your top three? Go on.
He's not in it anymore.
Why not?
In a bad way.
This
is my opinion.
Go on.
I know you should keep your opinion in the back pocket, but this is my opinion. He has done what he was on earth to do. He ain't going to do more. This is why you're meant to stop. Remember I said, you see, if I'm spitting, it's why I'm getting them hyper at 39 years old. Then who am I? Whatever. You know, like, you have to know when to stop. KRS-One did not stop until he got into an argument with Nelly talking about you're rubbish, Nelly, but Nelly sold like millions and millions.
So you're saying Kanye's got to give up sooner or later?
Listen, I'm not saying he's not good enough to carry on, but he has to stop. He has to. Because
already?
Because he can't do anything more.
But let me ask you
done.
A question. Who's better, Jay-Z or Kanye?
Jay-Z. And I don't even care
older.
About Jay-Z.
Jay-Z's older.
Yes, but Jay-Z is like his word and spoken teaching is more than Kanye.
Right. Okay.
As a teacher. Yeah.
Okay.
So who's in the top three?
None of them.
It's a whirly. Just intro your track because I can't talk right now.